we've got a Tenon Institute, piloted by Tin Chan. And he's just gone ahead with a very simple install over HQ, install over RD, take a credit, and get started. He's going to want to probably SF archive sooner rather than later to turn off run economy for Andromeda and to start blocking his ability.
Okay.
Oh my, it doesn't have anything better in there, eh?
I'm surprised he just... Oh, no, he did film. Career Pharaoh, okay.
Career Pharaoh, and Aaron Marone. Not great value. I'm wondering if this is a mulligan, because he seems unsure. Oh, he's going to let him into R&D. And he's just going to take an easy mark to red off the top. That's
okay.
How you start.
Okay, all right.
That is a really good way to start.
Yeah. So, sure gamble, Career Pharaoh, run. I say play sample thing, yeah. It's pretty good.
Dean's also on Moons, and he just wanted me to tell you this. HP sucks. Pass it on.
Now,
and that's going to see some more money, so now he'll be able to res the probably more expensive lights. But
I feel like Aaron probably wants to just either do a Fisk maybe to get a lot better cards. Yep, so one, two, three.
I mean, Tim is definitely just looking for some cards. The thing is that if he's flooding him, if the runner's flooding himself with cards, are they going to be able to fit in the run there?
I don't know about that. He's got 13 credits, or should he get 13?
He should be, but, sucks to be him.
I'm pretty sure it's supposed to be 13, unless it be...
We're not going to, but we are not, as a general rule, going to interfere with the game on stream.
Yeah.
It's unfair to treat this match any different.
I mean,
than
like
the
that stack of five may look like a six, but I feel like it's just a five.
No, he paid seven. Yeah, he's only got the five. Yeah. All
right.
It's his bad.
I mean, can't really. It's already too late for.
Where are yours?
Yeah, you can keep them. If we're up to Aaron, I just let both of them fire. Like, I don't think a medium. He's got two more.
Yeah, he's on three mediums.
Andy. So that's why we decided to put him on. Just wanted to see what his ideas were. He also has another medium in hand.
Which is cheaper than actually beating any of these traces.
Mm-hmm.
Well, actually, no. It's one of the traces is trace four, and he's got the link, so it wouldn't be the worst. Taking the net damage, the thing is, if he trashes the medium, takes net damage, he loses two mediums. So he's going to take the net.
Yeah. So
it might be that he...
Medium?
Yeah.
Oh, God. I mean, it happens.
And
a light
work, so he's losing his multi-access.
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
that's... Three net damage, is it?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah. Career Fair, leg working, yep. Okay.
And
I don't think Tim's gonna want to boost this. Just let it be. I don't like. You could be scared of a siphon. Yeah. I don't know.
He's just gonna keep it in play.
I don't think he should have.
And she's a piece of ice.
Yeah.
So that is gonna keep him at bay for a bit. That's not.
Yeah.
That's not.
So Fisk, medium run. Then we'll probably just draw. Yeah.
I mean, even with long moves, that's going to be six credits, so it'll keep him out of R&D for a little bit.
I mean, getting away from a Nisei is pretty good too early.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, sure.
That's good
there.
No, it's fine.
Yeah, it's fine where it is. Could we just get the
2 points up here?
But, I don't know, throw it to Tim, yeah,
put Prism on R&D. Might be a Caprice, just to have that extra little bit of defense. He's probably going to want to credit up, because he's got some ice spreads.
I feel like Aaron should run Archives. I don't know what you're afraid of. Make him pay money for it so he can't press hand.
I think you might be afraid of, Cobra or Cortex Lock. There are a few problematic pieces of ice that could really damn you.
I would say this should just be a setup turn. Just, you know, first action draw, credit, and then sure gamble. Just go next turn.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And might be thinking about running that remote, but oh, he gets it anyways. I mean, he just leaves it on the table. That could have been, that could have been Anise.
Seems so risky.
Oh, super risky. But
it's probably Jackson. It's, I think I saw him discard a.
So he's gonna Jackson draw.
I mean,
and
that's a power counter.
He's
I feel
actually
like
gonna create a remote. All right, and then a hedge fund. Good. Get a little bit more cash.
Okay, so we're gonna fist. He's gonna. He should wait until he discards.
Yeah.
I'll just remind Victor when he's free, just to get that switched up. Hey, Victor. When you go to the feature match table, can you ask Tim to switch the power token into an advancement counter? So Fisk, sure gamble. That's pretty good to get them really early.
Yeah.
What's his... Alias as his Sentry Breaker?
Ah, there it is, yeah. He just drew it.
Oh,
nicely done, buddy. Nicely done. Called it. So he's very focused on R&D, as we can tell with the mediums, but and Central Breakers as well. He doesn't really care about remotes. He's also buying Mobius to be able to make further runs. And if I recall correctly, his console is actually a doppelganger, so that he can pound R&D. What's interesting is that he declined to add Aeneas Informant to his deck, which you'd figure synergized quite well with repeated medium runs.
For sure. So, yes.
Yes, it has three medium.
We suspect why he has three, because he's playing a card called Demolition Run, so that when he sees a bunch of cards that he can't trash, he trashes them and then sends them away. So... Tim preemptively using Jackson Hauer, probably get rid of two face downs and hedge. Okay, so one face or
okay,
one
so
face down, IPO and hedge. Okay, okay. I would assume that the Icing HQ is probably Ice Wall, because I know that Tim's deck has mass commercialization.
It could be a Colossus. I am surprised that that he isn't spacing these out for mass commercialization.
Yep.
But the fact that he's doing several on one, I believe to me, would imply that it isn't a nice wall. It might be a Hordem, fearing some sort of AI breaker for a Siphon, and it might also be a Colossus.
That is true.
That's a friggin'
Aaron
beast.
Is playing one copy of Crypsis, but I don't think that's what he's afraid of.
I believe that he's probably thrown an agenda in here quite smartly as. He's not able to properly challenge this remote right now, having only a breach installed.
I would.
Which.
So for me here, I put, like, we haven't found any siphons yet. I feel like I should use Aaron counters to draw instead of like using clicks to do it. But. So.
He is going to have to be catching up.
Alias, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
And he's drawn into a Temujin contract, but it might be a few turns too late now that servers are closed off, essentially.
Yep.
It'll serve as a decent refund on repeated medium runs, but he doesn't have the base economy to get that started.
Yeah, we just want to talk a little, not too loud, because our commentating area is pretty close to the feature mesh, so it looks a little loud. But
we will try and bring the microphone audio up for you.
Yeah, draws extra cards, doesn't need... I tossed the other Aaron, I think he has it in his hand, I can't tell, but...
And I think that's what's going away, yeah. Yep. Toss the air.
Triple advance. Shimmer from Tenon. Yep.
And there's Mark II.
Yup.
Off to a good start for Tim.
Mm-hmm.
So that's gonna make it really a lot harder to land that first siphon. Next to impossible. And he's gone and just jammed another one in there.
Yep.
Because he got the free advancement, I guess.
Well, so what I think Aaron should do now is just land that siphon, or not siphon, land the Temujin into archives and just, you know, Tim probably wants to protect the remote, so he's probably not going to res anything.
That's fair, because if he does, if he lays down the Temujin, runs archives, and it's any ice of consequence, he might be able to go in and see what's in that archive.
For sure.
That remote. Mind you, if it's nothing in the remote, it will be all been for naught, and he'll be on low credits with very little way to challenge that archives for the Temujin credits.
For sure, for sure. I just want to double check if Tim's running any future perfects. No, he opted to switch away to Abo Kata protocol. So
a little bad luck with the draw on Aaron's side. Drawing into the multiples of his already installed breakers instead of more helpful cards that might be able to kickstart his economy. He is not running any Blue Moose or Daily Casts. He's invested heavily.
Oh, he is playing Daily Casts.
Oh, he is. My apologies. He's got three Daily Casts, but we just haven't seen any of them.
A whole lot, eh? Interesting. I don't know. I feel like he should just run and pressure this Archives, but whatever. He's going to toss...
Not that kind of player. Unfortunately, if this is yet another Nisei Mark II,
I don't think Tim would want to score it then, because then he gets hit by R&D very a lot. Like, let's say if it is.
It's R&D?
Yeah, because then he has the breaker for it. Maybe he's down to.
That may be true, yes. Like, so he gets the free advancement.
Or.
Now, if he's not going to score right now, though, is that the right place to place an advancement?
Think so. I don't
it
think
signals
so.
That there's something there.
It should. He should have put it somewhere else, but. If he doesn't want to score it now.
Right.
But. He might consider. Well, he does have copies of Trickle Light, so maybe he wants to do it the more cheaper way to score it.
Perhaps.
So he's got. Aaron's got 12 credits.
So Tim taking a moment to consider his options, viewing that that Aaron has enough money to properly pressure R&D. I mean, that is probably a Chrysium grid there. However, he's probably got the economies to deal with that, and he's not really in a position to res it. Three credits isn't usually a lot, but when you're on six credits, it's massive.
I think this is time to go to archives. Like, thank you.
That's gonna do some work. He's just so, draw and install it right away.
No, I think he used the air encounter to draw that.
Okay.
But
if you're installing this doppelganger, you got to start making runs, otherwise it's not doing anything.
That's right. No, don't look at the Mobius. It's not going to work. Okay, sweet. All right, okay.
This is an interesting choice.
Yeah. It's a run event that needs to go to R&D. So once you make it successful, you make another run, and then if it's then successful, you gain four.
So, I could definitely see him not resing this, but then resing a Chrysium grid.
Yep.
Just to deny him this this ability. Because you're going to likely get trashed, but that seems like a decent exchange.
I'm pretty sure Alias, when you use it, it's going to cost a million.
Because Alias, despite being a killer in the killer faction,
it's going to pay six credits to get it.
Yeah. It's going to be rather expensive.
Yep, there you go, six.
Six?
Or is it
Resident
five?
Chrysium?
I can't tell.
I'm not sure. So, Mobius fizzles, and it also procs Tim's ability.
Yep. If he doesn't make another successful throw.
Yeah. Now, I'm very much hoping.
Can we just get the stats on Alias?
Very much, I'm hoping for. An ice wall remote for Tim's sake, because otherwise he's in grave danger.
Oh, I'm gonna look it up.
I got it.
I figured, I thought it was 6 to break through that, but could be wrong. It looks like he peed 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, no? Starts with 1 strength, right?
Yeah. Well, that's on Tim.
Okay. Well, actually, it's also on the runner, too.
It should have been...
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yeah.
I think he paid 5.
He did.
So wouldn't that be a technicality on both?
It's on both players to keep an eye on their credits.
So I'm just gonna step out.
We've got a Temujin, and it's gonna be put on archives. And bringing out a Torzhog City Grid Mark server.
Just gonna just double check, because I think he did. He didn't. Because I'm pretty sure we both counted that it was 5 credits going away. But I mean,
it's in the past now.
Yep. So Temujin on archives, I assume.
Yes. Okay. Mark the server.
I just run it. Like, where's he gonna res the 3, right?
He might. It might just be an ice wall, which would not. There should be something. So he's making that run, and he's gonna res that rainbow. Is this the last click? If it's not,
I think he's got one more. Well, that's cheap. So he Mobius, Temujin, run, bounce. No, run the.
This was a mistake.
Should have ran the. Would you have run the?
Absolutely, for sure. So, I mean, Tim made a mistake, but he was not punished for it.
Yes. Now what Tim's gonna do is gonna gain a credit. He's gonna trick a light and score that. I hope so.
It's probably ideal. Or if he has a nice wall there, just click for credits. I mean,
yeah.
Yes, he is running. I believe it's spear fishing and inside job.
Yep, there it is. He's doing it.
Get that first breakthrough. I see. He would have been okay with him scoring that medical breakthrough. It's not ideal putting him at 4 points, but
okay.
But
so,
Ice on the Remote is vanilla, even better. I don't know. Back to the Beat indicates that it's
so vanilla. Aaron can net 1 credit by running it to archives. Don't really like that.
No, if you don't have some way to synergize with archives, this is a good res. If there is vanilla on the remote, because he's at 2 credits and he's
Let's
got very little way.
He does not
have a
vanilla in his list, so.
So that was a spicy, dicey res.
Yep. You think Tim's holding a bunch of agendas in it?
He's scored 2 of them out, and he's not drawn that many cards.
Yeah,
I think it's
HQ.
Fine.
I wouldn't. You
can spend 2 to see one card in HQ.
I wouldn't.
I mean, it does turn off the ability for 1 turn, but that seems like a lot to spend. So just examining the ID to try and see what it says. Unfortunately, it doesn't say anything intelligible unless you're able to read whatever language that's printed in. So he's decided to
It does cost quite a bit. Economy,
just a little bit. And it's gonna hurt because that daily cast is not gonna pay off quickly enough to turn off Tenon's ability. And Tenon at this point is steamrolling towards a very sure victory. That's scored in his A token. Now it is gonna be a while before he can score the 5-3 necessary to win the game. Is he even running any 5-3s, I wonder? Yes, he's running two Obakata protocols. And depends on what he's seeing. He could score two more 2-pointers as well. But
this is what I like about medical preview is that when he scores the next one, it's going to be a 3-2.
Yeah,
then
the next
one you just go, it's all advance, boom.
But in every deck in which I've used medical breakthrough, I've never scored the third one. Maybe once. Like, what are the odds you're going to see all three of that agenda?
It's very nice when it happens. Very nice when it happens. Oh, my God.
That does
another
not feel good.
Mobius. Dear.
Unfortunately, this is simply a very bad matchup.
Yes.
Because he's all in on one particular central, and Tim has every reason to protect his centrals and is able to.
Yeah, he's playing 3 Chrissian in a friend high place. So not only you have to trash it for paying 5, you can just bring it back.
You're never gonna it's gonna be rare that he sees more than one card, and he'll never get that Mobius fire. He'll never get the Timogen fire.
You can account safe, and then he's gonna Chrissium grid you, which really sucks.
Oh, it will drain him of those 3 credits, but is that significant?
No, he's going to. Is it 1 to break?
2.
Okay.
And 3 to res a Chrissium.
Yep, he just has the right amount of money. Yep.
Ouch.
Sick.
So he is going to go for the access.
Yep. Sick.
I mean, depending on what you're holding agendas in hand, it might be okay to just let that fire because he's going to have to clear those tags.
Well, no, that's what Aaron's for. Well, this
that's
gives
true.
You
never mind.
More inclination to not trash Chris because he has friends in high places.
Yeah, you never trash those guys.
No. Yep.
Now, so the only way he has into that remote and, are inside jobs, spearfishing, and a single Crypsis. And you need a huge economy. Aaron is going to have a very difficult time winning this game. Tim's only on 3 credits. He's clicking for credits, and he's in a very, very strong position.
If it were up to me, just draw it like mad, man. Mm-hmm. Like, we need to find a way to.
He has to draw because the 5 cards he has in hand, none of them are answers.
Yep. I actually don't know what the last card is.
It's a doppelganger.
Oh, doppelganger, right.
And you're not making any successful runs, so you're not going to run again. And where are you running anyways?
That's not going to do anything.
Well, it will keep you from hurting yourself on an Obakata protocol, but I'm not sure that it's worth at this point the clicking credit you require to install it.
If he really doesn't want the Tenon ability to fire, he could run Archives for net 1 credit because he has Temujin on there.
and Mr. D'Alessandri, loving doppelganger. Mr. D'Alessandri just won. Is it John D'Alessandri? I think it's John D'Alessandri. Just won regionals with Andy Deck that used doppelganger.
Nice.
Still a good card.
Yeah.
So Aaron thinking long and hard about how he's going to approach this game. I mean, I don't think he realizes.
Unhappy doppelganger here.
I don't think he realizes that he's able to get the same effect by going to archives.
Yes.
And then if while it's not ideal, it's never going to get better.
Yep. Doppelganger. Put the counter on this piece of ice in front of HQ. Just make it look. See what he draws.
Actually. I don't think he actually makes any money by running archives.
What? Why not?
Because they each breaker cost four or five.
For but I thought to break with Alias, it's two to pump to three, four strength, and then one to break.
Oh, you're right. My bad.
I mean, it's not the best, but oh, he is gonna do it. So run archives. Yep, net down. Exciting in those. Then double ganger run. Go again. Yeah. Might as well. Okay.
I don't think I would run again. I would just click for a credit. I mean, you use that to deny the tenant ability over the course of the next five turns. That's all it's good for.
I feel like he should have just shot that into a different server. Like, he didn't need to go back into archives.
He could have challenged the remote, but I think if it's something bad, it's bad because there's nothing you can do about it with these central breakers.
Draw, yeah. Click two, draw. There's a Crypsis.
Ooh, an alt art Crypsis. Fancy.
That's just a game two.
Fancy.
And then next time.
Toss a Mobius.
Yep.
Like,
I don't want to show the Crypsis right now. So he tosses
them. He's going to hold on to Mobius because he's hoping that they'll fire. Hoping that they'll make do some work, but they're not going to.
So, like, it's going to cost 6 to get into Assassin, 5 to dredge Chrysian, so that's 11. And we don't even know what the front piece of ice is. It could be even as well be a code game.
Yeah. And the, you see clicking for credits on a hedge fund. That works.
This deck does have two political operatives. It does, but
it's
gonna
never
be,
gonna see. It might hit the table.
It's gonna be hard. It's gonna be hard considering that there's.
But if he wants to make any appropriate action against HQ, it's going to be expensive.
It's interesting that
that ice ball now costs four to break.
Aaron's Andy does not have a current.
Oh, he's going to defend archives a little bit more. You could still pressure that, but I believe Tim is fighting for his tenant ability.
Yep, I think that's a good idea to do.
It's very interesting to see an HQ so lightly defended against a criminal.
I mean,
the
like,
Chrysium is the Chrysium
it's
is doing
just
a lot
the
of work.
Breach is so painful.
But breach breaking ice wall four credits.
I'm surprised that Aaron has decided to use breach instead of paperclip.
Well, if he ran paperclip, he would be running one less medium.
Yeah, I mean, like, dude.
That's not what he wants to do.
It seems so excessive for three mediums, that's all.
I'm going to trust that he's going through his deck and has found that it's going all in on.
Yeah.
I mean, he's got great HQ pressure as a.
So wait.
As a criminal would.
So he pays two to pump and two to break.
He's paying four, yeah.
But didn't he just shift up two? I don't get it.
I don't know.
Oh man, okay.
But it's on these players. It's on these players to
trash
understand.
It.
Oh, yeah.
Wow, that's quite.
Is he gonna same old siphon here?
I don't know about the.
He did pay for it. Yeah, I'm not worried about it.
Yeah. Like. Yeah, let's go siphon. Yeah. Now he's just gonna end the run.
Yeah, that's fine.
But if I was Tim, I'd keep it. That ability of
so he ends the run, but he's also getting his tenant proc this way. Isn't that, like the thing is that I mean Tim doesn't know this, but Tim probably suspects it, that Andy is gonna have a very difficult time getting into a remote as it is.
Yep.
That's a political operative, so we're probably going to see friends bring Chrysler back.
So painful.
Finally tossing a Mobius.
Yeah. Where did that...
Victor's picked it up. I'm not sure what's happening.
Nope, that's not where
that's
that...
not where it's going. Put it back on already.
Huh?
Yeah. And this might actually be the game.
Yeah, you could just score an avocado, right?
Yeah.
So if you trick, shipment.
No, just trick, mint, and transit.
In advance twice.
Yeah. But if you had that, I'm sure we would be done.
Yes. But I feel like it might be a... based on how much he's delaying, I feel like it's a...
If it's not the game...
Medical breakthrough? If Nisei? Yeah, it could be another Nisei.
If he's deciding to trick or not.
Yeah. If it was a medical breakthrough, he could score that and still friends.
Yes.
Kazuma.
So he's going to manually...
Advance
he's going to do mass commercialization. Yeah, makes sense. Gain 8.
I guess he didn't feel like he had to put the Krizian back right now because of how low...
Tim's not pressured to defend or with Krizian anyway, so... One more click. You must have drawn.
He may have.
So draw, C-siphon, draw,
He advanced one of his ice in order to make a better mass commercialization.
That's exactly what it was. Alright, so draw, credit, I toss a Mobius and pull up. Like, Mobius isn't going to do anything.
You're never going to install that second medium either.
By breach.
So you think it's this point?
Hmm?
This
has got
to be
good. It might be.
Yep. That could be a 2. Like, I think Tim really wanted to protect the... Yeah, triple advance 3 times. And... There it is. Okay.
Tim.
Yeah, I think Tim had the commanding start. I think also Aaron had a pretty bad starting hand.
He
got a Nisei early, but...
But he career-fared an Aaron
Marone.
Yes. He didn't have the Temujins, he didn't have the... daily cast.
Yeah, we never got to see any Hernando.